Hello friends, welcome back to the Global Studio YouTube channel. In this video, we will discuss about revolve and extrude commands in Solidworks. And we will also discuss the right way to use these two commands. Because I have noticed many people use these two tools incorrectly when creating a 3D model. To understand this concept, let's begin with an example of a shaft model. Many people draw the shaft using the extrude option. Do you think this is the right way to draw a shaft? The answer is no. Using the extrude command is completely wrong and an unprofessional approach for creating a model, as it takes more time and challenging to modify. Moreover, it does not even align with the manufacturability of the part, because the part is produced using the turning process. So in that case, what's the correct way to draw a shaft? Always draw the shaft using the revolve command, as it allows you to complete the process in a single step. Now we will try this in a software. Go to Solidworks and select the right plane to create a sketch. Take the line option and create a profile like this. And feel free to experiment with the different sketches, but I will draw a simple one here for your reference. Exit the sketch to apply the revolved boss or base option, and then select the axis to create a revolved part. Keep the direction angle as 360 degree and finally click on OK to create the part. Now if I want to modify the length of the shaft, then I can simply go to the model sketch to modify the length. It's that simple. Any modifications made in the sketch will directly reflect in the 3D model. But if we want to create the same shaft using the extrude option, then first we should start by creating a circular sketch on a plane. Afterwards, we should extrude it to a certain distance to generate a shaft feature. To add another feature with a different diameter, we have to create a different sketch and extrude commands. For various shaft sizes, we have to create different sketches and features on different planes. This process is time consuming and definitely not a professional way to design a shaft. If the shaft can be drawn using the revolve method, then what is the use of extrude commands? The answer is very simple. You can use the extrude option where the revolve option is not possible to use. Some examples include square, triangles, and hexagonal features where you cannot use the revolve option. And one more important point to remember, if there is any revolved cut in a part, please use the revolved cut option or hole wizard option instead of the extruded cut option. I hope all the above mentioned points are very useful and clear for you. And with that, we have reached the end of the video. Thank you for watching. We will meet again in the next video. Until then, goodbye.